In the 18th and 19th century, there was a bit of a vampire hunting frenzy. You don't have to look very far in history to find a story that is more batshit crazy than anything you can make up. And this is what I love about history, but also about vampires. Because you have these characters that could have seen anything. They could have met Marie Antoinette, they could have met Henry VIII or Robin Hood, they could have dug up a body and burnt its heart on the town green. So if you want to stop the vampires in your village, it would be helpful if you were born on a Saturday, because apparently this means you'll be able to see the vampires that other people find invisible. You're going to need your usual things. Crucifix, holy water, maybe garlic, and definitely a stake. These things can be found in vampire hunting kits, one of which was on display at the Great Exhibition in Victorian London. There's one more thing you're going to need. A very strong stomach. Because apparently it's not enough to stop vampires with sunlight and holy water, or even decapitation. No, no. The best way to stop a vampire is to cut out its heart and then burn it. Because that sounds like a party. In 1892, a 19-year-old girl named Mercy Brown died in Connecticut of tuberculosis. 10 years earlier, her mother had died, and then a year after that, her sister. Her brother started to sicken and was sent away for his health. Now, at that time, Mercy had probably already contracted the same tuberculosis as her family. However, she was asymptomatic. She lived for 10 more years perfectly healthy. And then, unfortunately, at 19, she died. By that time, her brother had returned from abroad and was also starting to sicken. So about 2 months after her death, her father and her doctor dug up her body, cut out her heart and her liver, and burnt it on a stone. But that's not all. They took the ashes of the heart, mixed it with water, and fed it to Edwin, her brother, hoping that it would cure him. Spoiler alert, it didn't. Because heart smoothie. History's weird. Kinda awesome. Hers was definitely not the only heart that was burnt. In 1817, Frederick Ransom's heart was burnt in the blacksmith's forge. In 1830, in Woodstock, Vermont, a heart was also burnt on the town green. Although heart burning was prominent in Vermont, Connecticut, and Long Island, it was also quite common in Europe. As with the stories of people coming back from the dead. In Serbia in the 1700s, we have the story of Peter Plagojevic. Unfortunately, he died. The thing is, he died of a mysterious illness. And then in the following weeks, 9 more people died of that same mysterious illness. What really stood out in the story is that all 9 people had dreams the day before they died that Peter was in their room trying to strangle them. In fact, 3 days after Peter died, his son saw him in the kitchen asking for food. And the next day, the son was dead. So understandably, his wife fled the country when she had a vision of Peter demanding shoes. Because apparently, shoes. The army was called in to exhume Peter, and they reported that they found him still breathing, with his eyes moving, and that they staked him for the good of the village. But the vampire frenzies of the 18th and 19th century weren't all about tuberculosis and burning hearts. They were also predated by experiences with famine. In 1609, in the American colony of Jamestown, they had a famine. A really, really bad famine. They ate the dogs, they ate the horses, they ate the cats, they ate the rats. It was like a really creepy Dr. Seuss story. Basically, they were really hungry. So hungry, in fact, that they drank the blood of the people too weak to fight them off. And then they started digging up the bodies. They apparently ate the livers, the brains, and I quote, the face meat. Face meat. I can't know this alone. You're welcome. So vampire stories within history and folklore are, to be fair, known to be rather melodramatic. So did this happen? I'm glad you asked. Because yes. Because in 2012, an archaeologist found the body of a girl they named Jane at Jamestown, and her skull bore the marks of somebody whose brain had been eaten. And once again, I quote, the marks were professional looking. So they'd eaten a lot of brain, and they were clearly very hungry. So why this pastime of digging up bodies? If you picture yourself about 300 years ago, either during a famine or during an outbreak of something like the plague or tuberculosis, that fear will make you do a lot of things. It'll also make you try and fix the problem. So there's a sense of control where you think you're helping. You think you're stopping this disease, whether it's a vampire or tuberculosis, by doing something like burning the heart or the liver. Heart burning. Coming to a 19th century town near you. Be safe from the vampires. Protect your family. Burn a heart today. Don't burn a heart. It's not okay.